Hello students, welcome to Misostudy again. So we were discussing about complex permanent tissue. In that complex permanent tissue, we were discussing about phloem. So let's revise what we have done first, then we'll proceed further. Complex permanent tissue. Complex permanent tissue is that tissue which is made up of different type of cells, right? And in this complex permanent tissue, we have described and we have already studied about the two types of the complex permanent tissue. First one is called as a xylem and second is called as a phloem. Xylem and second is called as a phloem. Xylem is that element which help in conduction of water and minerals. Whereas a phloem, they help in conduction of food, and food is mainly translocated in the form of sucrose. Now, to talk about this xylem, in the case of xylem, we have talked about the different cellular structures. Hope you remember those sessions when I have discussed about the xylems, different type of structures which is present in case of the xylem. First is called as a tracheids. Second is called as a vessels, tracheids, second is called as a vessel. Third one, that is called as a fiber, xylem fiber, and the fourth one is called as a xylem parenchyma. This we have already completed, right? Now, we were on to the topic of a phloem which help in conduction of food. Now, the different type of phloem that we know are basically four types are there. The first one is called as a sieve tube. Second one is called as a companion cells. Third one is called as a fibers. So, phloem fiber. And the fourth one, like that of xylem, they are called as a phloem parenchyma. Right, these are the four types. Sieve tubes we have already discussed. What are sieve tubes? Sieve tubes are those structures, basically they are not made up of only a single cell. Rather than multiple cells are there and they join end to end and they form as a sieve tube, which help in a movement of water from the movement of food from the source to sink. So this is called as a sieve tube. Rest is companion cells, rest are the phloem fibers and the phloem parenchyma. Now, come to this side. In the previous session, I have made this diagram. Right, hope you remember. This is how a phloem look like, a typical phloem look like. In this, I have mentioned the three type of cells. Let's label these three type of cells, then I'll proceed towards the companion cells and likewise we'll proceed forward. So firstly, can you see these structure? This structure is called as a sieve tube cells. So these sieve tube cells which are present, they are present one above the another and likewise they form a tubular structure which help in translocation of food from an area where the photosynthesis happen to the area where photosynthesis doesn't happen or the regions which require food. Now, in this case, these are the cells. These cells and these cells, they are called as a companion cell. Companion cell. Now, what is companion cell? As the name indicate, companion cells, these are the specialized type of parenchymatous cells. They have a nucleus present, whereas in case of the sieve tube cell, have you ever seen these nucleus? I have drawn the nucleus over here. Nucleus is not there. Instead, they are having a peripheral cytoplasm present like this. They form a tunnel like structure which help in translocation of the food, translocation of the different minerals from the different regions. As the name indicates, companion cells, specialized parenchymatous tissue, which remain in association with the sieve tube cell. Sieve tube cells, no nucleus is there. In the companion cells, we can see the nucleus is there. That means, but still we consider the sieve tube cell as a living cell. The reason is that those work which has to be done by the nucleus of the sieve tube, that is done with the help of the nucleus of companion cell. That's why the name is given as a companion cell. Now, in between these sieve tube cells and in between these companion cells, this area, or you can say the membrane, the cell wall which is present over here, they show a pit field structure in which the overall diameter of the cell membrane or the cell wall is very less, due to which their content can easily move from one cell to another. That is the reason companion cell nucleus can control the sieve tube cells. These sieve tube cells, they are connected to one another. They are connected to one another and they are having a sieve plate present. So, this is called as a sieve plate. They are having these sieve plate present, and these sieve plates, they are having a perforations present like this. These perforation allow a continuous movement of food from one place to another. Along with this, one specialized kind of cells are present, which we call it as a phloem parenchyma. Right. Along with this, one more typical cell is present, which is called as a phloem fiber. And these phloem fiber, they help in giving a mechanical support to the whole structure that I have not drawn in this. So, hope the things are clear to you about the different type of cells. Now, come to this side again. Now, let's discuss about these companion cells and like we will proceed further. First of all, I'll discuss about this companion cells. So, first, discuss about the companion cells. So, what are companion cells? These are specialized parenchymatous cells. Specialized parenchymatous cells. Right? These cells are also living cells. Another feature is that they are also living cell. And we know that in this case, the nucleus is present, the cytoplasm, the protoplasm, each of these things are present. Right? Hope you are getting what I am trying to say. So, living cells are there, they are having a nucleus also, they are having a cytoplasm also present. Now, in this case, they are attached to, they are found in close association, they are found in close association with sieve tube cells, sieve tube cells, right? And they retain nucleus throughout the life. Nucleus throughout the life. These are called as a companion cell. Now, one more important structure is present in case of companion cell, which is called as a pit field. Pit field. Pit field. So, what is pit field? Pit field is a region of which the two cells, they are joined together. So, place of association. Place of association of two cells, companion cells and sieve tube cells. sieve tube cells have thin walled membrane. Which we call it as a pit field, so that any messenger, any substance can easily transfer to the another cells. This is the place from where companion cell nucleus control these sieve tube cells. So messenger substance which are secreted in companion cells, they can easily transported to the another part, that is called as a sieve tube cells. And the sieve tube cells, that's why it is said that the sieve tube cells and the companion cells, they are evolved together in the course of evolution. Sieve tube cells and companion cells evolved together in the course of evolution. So, are you getting what I am trying to say? Very important, that can be asked. Very important line, right? Now question arises where these sieve tube, where this companion cells, they are present. Now come to this side. Companion cell companion cells are present in angiosperm. Angiosperm, right? And they are absent in pteridophytes and gymnosperm. Right. To talk more about this, now what is present in case of the pteridophyte and the gymnosperm? Because in this case also the sieve cells are present rather than the sieve tubes. They have a sieve cells present, even though sieve cells doesn't have a nucleus. In case of the sieve tube cells, I have already explained that in sieve tube cells, they are not present in case of the gymnosperm and not present in, they are not present in case of the gymnosperm and the pteridophyte, right? And also in this case, the special type of cells which form a tunnel like structure, which is called as a sieve cells, is present in these case. These sieve cells, they are also having a sieve plate present, and this sieve plate is not present on the end wall, rather than they are present on the lateral wall. So they are also, they do not have a nucleus also. So in this case also they do not have a nucleus, but they are still considered as a living cells because they are associated with, in these cases they are associated with in pteridophyte and gymnosperm. Sieve cells are associated with albuminous cell. Now, question arises, what is albuminous cells? They are just like that of the companion cells and they have a nucleus present in them. Right? So, we have discussed about the first, second type of the phloem, second type of the cells of the phloem, that is a companion cells. Right? So, students, first of all, note down this, then we will proceed further. So, students, hope you have noted down about this companion cells. Now, one more thing that I would like to ask, other than providing the nucleus, what is the function of these companion cells? Companion cells, they help in maintaining. I am talking about the functions. Companion cells help in maintaining pressure gradient. For translocation of food. This is a function of them. Right? So, we have discussed about these two types. Now, we have to discuss about the phloem fibers. Now, I have written over here the pressure gradient. Come to this side. I would like to explain you about the pressure gradient. As I am saying, suppose the two regions are present. This is called as a source region. Suppose below we have is a source region and above we have is a sink region. I want my food has to be translocated from source to the sink region. The food is being transferred opposite to the gravitational force. The chances that it may come back to the original position because of the gravitational force. So, these companion cells, they undergo certain kind of contraction and relaxation due to which they form a pressure gradient due to which the food is being translocated from the source to the sink region. Right? This is a function of companion cells. Now, come to this side. Let's talk about the third type, which is called as a phloem fiber. So, what is phloem fiber? Phloem fiber are long, pointed, needle-like cells. Third one, long pointed needle like cells. And also they are sclerenchymatous. Sclerenchymatous cells. In these cells, we cannot see any kind of branching present. So, no branching is present in this case. Right? When we see the structure of these cells, their cell wall is very much thickened due to which they are having a very less lumen. Cell wall thickened. And they have is a narrow lumen. Right? Initially, when these cells they are born or they are when they are formed, they are living. But during the course of time, they become dead and they loses their protoplasm. With due time, phloem fiber loses their vitality by losing nucleus and protoplasm. As we have already discussed, in the protoplasm, the major constituent is water. 70% it is made up of water. So, this is a phloem fiber. So, let's see how these phloem fiber, they look like. I want some different colors. So, to talk about this phloem fiber, this is how the phloem fibers look like. Pointed, tapered towards the end, no branching can be seen, and thickened cell wall and very less lumen is present in this case. Right? So, these are thick cell wall and they have this narrow lumen. Right? Now, question arises, what is the function of these phloem fiber? You must have heard of flex, you must have heard of the jute fibers, the hemp fiber. All of these, they are nothing but a phloem fiber because of their hard structure. And also one more thing that I would like to discuss, that they are present in case of secondary phloem. They are not present in case of primary phloem. They are present only in secondary phloem. So, when secondary phloem is formed? During the secondary growth. Right? Not during the primary growth or primary phloem. So, this is a phloem fiber and we have to discuss about the uses as well. Uses, phloem fiber are used as jute, they are used as hemp and flex. Right? So, this is all about a phloem fiber. So, we have discussed the second part, which is called as a third part, which is called as a phloem fiber. Now, we have is a next that is called as a phloem parenchyma. Now, let's see how this phloem parenchyma are like. These are elongated structure. As usual, it is saying that they are made up of parenchymatous cells. As they are made up of these parenchymatous cells, that means these are the cells which have a very good capability of storage. For example, they do store the mucilage as well. They do store of some white secretion, for example, the latex. So, whenever these substances, they come out, this is because of the presence of phloem parenchyma. So, next we have is the fourth one we have is a phloem parenchyma. Phloem parenchyma. As usual, elongated cells, they have is a dense cytoplasm, also they have is a nucleus present in them, also we can see these are those type of cells which are connected to one another with the help of a connection, and that connection is called as a plasmodesmata. So, plasmodesmata join one parenchymal cells to another. Right, very important. Now, one more important thing is where these are present. We cannot specify that they are only present in case of the secondary phloem as that of the phloem fiber. They are present in case of the primary phloem as well as secondary phloem. Present in primary and secondary phloem. primary and the secondary phloem. Now let's talk about a function of these. As we all know, the basic function of these phloem is a translocation of food. In this case, these are those type of cells which can store large amount of food in them. So the first function, we all know it is clear, that is storage of food. So these are phloem parenchyma. They help in storage of food. Right? Now, another function is that they also store a white color substances, and they depend upon the species to species. They also store this oil, gum, mucilage, latex, etc. So what is latex? Latex is white color substance that ooze out, and mucilage is somewhere the transparent substance that ooze out from the different branching. Right? So today we have completed one very important topic, that is a complex permanent tissue. We have done with it. Now we will proceed towards a different tissue system. We will be talking about the ground tissue system, we will be talking about the vascular tissue system, and we will be talking about the very important epidermal tissue system. So different tissue system first of all we will discuss, and then we will proceed towards a different kind of structures, or how there is a different arrangement towards whether this ground tissue system or this epidermal tissue system is present in case of the different plants, like dicot plant, like monocot plant, stem, root, leaves, etc. We will be discussing that. Right. So, hope that today's session, which is related to the different sieve tube, companion cells, phloem fibers and the phloem parenchyma, is clear to you. Hope you all are preparing your notes as well. Students always gets confused regarding in this chapter, that is anatomy of flowering plants. Don't get confused. Just go with the flow. Revise the things once, twice and thrice. Things will be clear in your mind, and also maintain your notes as well. Right. Whatever I am diagram which I am making, we are going very slow so that the things should be clear to your mind. In case you find any kind of query, in case you find any kind of difficulty in learning all those things, you can also contact us. You can also write the questions to us. We have a doubt clearing sessions also. You can also write these questions which you have there in your mind. We will call. We will definitely in contact with you, and we will help you. So till then, take care of yourself, prepare your notes, and also take out the questions as well, because then only I'll be able to understand that you people are also studying. So thank you so much, students, for watching this. We'll meet you next session.